Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So the bin that I was letting dry out yesterday has 3/4 of a pound in it. I sifted it out and I took the cocoons and I put them up here on the wall just so I could, I put them here just so I could moisten them and put newspaper when I'm done. So these are the worms that were in there and I'm trying to get like the stuff off of them, their bedding, which I will reuse. And weigh them and see what we're up to here. So it's December 2nd today. Are you all getting ready for the holidays? For those of you that celebrate the holidays, we are. And today I'm not feeling too great. People at my job are a little sick, so, and the public, you know, I think it's spreading. So Joe last night, he did the dishes for me and he got us dinner ready for when I got home from work. I don't have to really do anything. Today I could just come down here and work with my worms and lunch will be ready. So shout out to Joe. He's a great help. He really is. So this is what we're gonna do today. Now these bins, breeder bins, should be sifted every 3 weeks. I guess no matter what, that's what the commercial world says. So, and I usually do, sometimes it's 4 weeks, just depends on what I see. Sometimes my best judgment is just to trust my own instincts, you know, and that's what I do. So some people have asked me if I have like a mailbox or something. I do have a PO box. I'll link it down below in the comments. If you want to send me like a Christmas card or anything, you could send it there. Last year I had one of my viewers send me this really cool t-shirt. It's a worm farming t-shirt. I'll wear it next time I'm down here. Sometimes I don't like wearing it down here because it's so cute. I don't want to like destroy it. But then I'm thinking, well, that's part of it. And I don't think she cares if I destroy it. It's really cute though. So yeah, that was a nice thing to receive. And thank you all for the new subscribers. And I read all your comments and your words of encouragement. You know, I really love them. So, and always keep your comments to like, you know, say something positive, any negative comments or spamming, like advertising your own business or channel on my comments, will be removed. It really goes against YouTube's policy and it's seen by the YouTube community as not respectful and kind of tacky, and that's a good way for your channel to be spammed. So you can comment on other people's videos, and trust me, if you're a worm farmer or crochet or whatever, people will see your face and your name, so they'll automatically probably go over there. But yeah, advertising under someone else's video is not a good practice for YouTube, and I would hate to see some people's channels disappear because of it, you know. YouTube is kind of strict about things like that. YouTube does have adjustments in your settings to where you can allow every single comment, or it can filter out like inappropriate things too, because sometimes I have like people link inappropriate websites underneath my comments, and when I see them, I do my best to remove them. But YouTube has been doing a good job at helping me with that and, you know, removing them themselves. Like, they never appear. It's kind of like a block. So there was one comment made recently that didn't appear in public, but I saw it. And it was because YouTube caught it and didn't post it publicly. So I was able to take it down. So they blocked it. So yeah, YouTube does a good job at stuff like that. So I'm glad. I'm glad they have that. And I'm glad that I'm able to film videos with them because I really enjoy it. So my other channel, it's been like 3 weeks since I did a video because I'm trying to get through the holidays and through my holiday season with this channel and my business. But the other one, I'm going to start like I did with this one. Just start posting regularly and show you all the other crazy things I do. So there was someone that commented that they love all my stories of things that happened to me. Oh my gosh, do I have stories. Okay, I'll tell you one while I do this. So, you know, Joe and I've been together for like 28 years. We've kind of grown up together and, you know, did a lot in our youth. And we still do stuff. But we grew up in Jersey. And one time, he said, let's go to the zoo. I think it was the zoo. I don't know if it was some other farm, but it was something that had to do with llamas. So naturally we go, and the llamas, you can go in and pet them and feed them. You know, it was so cool. Well, the llamas left everyone alone but me, of course. So I'm getting some food and a llama comes behind me and jumps on me. There must have been poop on the hoofs, their feet. So I had poop from the back of my neck, down my back, down my pants, like my butt, down to the back of my knees. Yep. I don't know what that llama's intentions were, but obviously it wasn't good. So yeah, that happened to me once. So let me know down below if you want to hear more stories. I have so many stories. So that was interesting. I mean, it scared the life out of me, and Joe, of course, laughed his head off. So yeah, next time I video, let's see if I'll remember, I'll tell you about the goose. That's a whole another story. So, and thank you to the people that say that they like my enthusiasm and my personality. I told you I do laugh a lot. I just naturally do. I can't help it. But, you know, I figured I'd rather be like that than be a sourpuss. You know, I've seen some YouTube channels where people, they almost look angry. So, I'm just being myself, you know. I can never change. It just brings me joy. I watch a lot of TikTok and I just stroll through and I watch so many funny videos. My go-to on TikToks are usually, well, obviously worm farming, but I watch a lot of like cute little chihuahua things, but I watch a lot of blooper videos, comedy things that people do. People are so funny. And sometimes I just laugh to myself, you know, out loud. And Joe hears me. He's like, oh, what are you doing? I'm laughing at TikTok. So Joe and I send each other a lot of videos on Instagram too, of just some funny stuff that happens. And he says something funny and he thinks I'm going to like it. He'll send it to me. And we go back and forth on Instagram. But once in a while we do that on TikTok too. So it's fun. It's fun. I know some people don't like TikTok, and that's okay. You know, you don't have to like it. I love it. And they made a video a couple of years ago that they thought they were going to take it down. I was like, no, I almost started crying, but no, not really. But I like it. I'm glad that YouTube is starting to do shorts, like the reels, like TikTok, because let me tell you, I have gone through them. I have seen so many worm farming ones, and I really like them. So YouTube, keep them coming. So we're gonna weigh these. I started out with 3/4 of a pound. I don't know how. 3 weeks ago, I start with 3/4 of a pound, and then I weigh it, and sometimes there's more worms. I'm wondering if when I start with the 3/4, there's cocoons. They hatch, or there's little babies and they've hatched and I don't see them, and then they just start growing really fast, adding more weight to the mass. That's my guess. Again, it's just a theory, but you know, I don't think it's a bad theory. So anyway, I'm gonna reset these worms. So let's just weigh them and just see what I have here. I have this little handy scale. See, I put the thing on it and I set it to zero. Thank you, Heather, by the way, if you're watching. Heather loves my worm chow. I just shipped her some. And thank you all for supporting my business. I mean, I'm a small home business. I don't have all the million acres and the giant barns, and that's okay. Maybe someday I'll get there. But for now, this is what I like doing. Let me see. Let me get them all in there. And I know there's a little bit of bedding on them. Honestly, it doesn't make a huge difference. So how did I go from 3/4 pound to that? That all that extra weight cannot be the little bit of bedding that's there. Like these little flakes, it can't be. So that's my only theory, you know. So I'm gonna take them, and now I have a pound and a quarter. So I can put them back in the same breeder bin, or like other worm farmers do that I know, and it's a good practice, I can divide that. And a pound and a quarter, I would divide that into 4 or even 5 separate grow out bins, the breeder bins that go on the wall. So I'm gonna get the bedding ready for those, and then we're gonna do that. So for this one, let's say I'm gonna measure 1/4 pound. So look, that's about 1/4 pound. I hate that I get a reflection. Anyway, I hope you can see that. It's at the number 4. So I'm gonna take that and put it here. So these worms, in 3 weeks, they're gonna be harvested. So for them to reproduce well, you know, you have to keep the bedding moist. I know you've heard me tell you that. And you got to feed them on a regular basis. Don't let them run out of food, because it's almost like to get them to reproduce for you, you got to spoil them, make them happy, make them think they live in the lap of luxury. Like, oh, we can reproduce here. Our mom's got us, you know, so that way they'll do that for you. And all right, this is one bin I got ready. So I have coconut coir in there and pine shaves mixed in, and I have some oyster grit. I will be using more peat moss, but I'm waiting for the peat moss to come back in the spring, because I ran out of it, and my mistake was I didn't load up in the late summer before fall came, and obviously it ran out. So I'm using what I have, and in the spring I'm going to load up, and then Joe said by the end of summer, before the fall, when all this peat moss starts going on sale, I'm just going to load it up and maybe like store it somewhere in the garage or something, so I could always have it. So anyway, today is Friday and we're gonna keep going with this. So I have another tip for you guys. So I just put these worms here, the little 1/4 pound to grow out. Label your bins immediately, because one time I put them on the wall and I said, well, I'll label them at the end. Well, guess what? I forgot. So I had to guess the dates. And it didn't make a big deal, but it threw off my days. So I'll never do that again. So label your bins immediately when you have finished setting them up. So I set them up today, 1/4 pound. In 3 weeks, it'll be the 23rd of December, and that's when I will harvest. So the week before, or not even a week before, because this room is getting really warm, a few days before, I'll uncover this and I'll start fluffing it up so it can dry out a little bit. So what I've done is I took the other bin that was full of adult worms, and I'm sifting them out for the cocoons. So here are the cocoons, and I'm sure tiny babies in here, because there's always a few that hatch here and there. And I'm going to put them there. And then once I have that set over there, I'm going to water it all down, label it, and put it on the wall. My breeder bins here are growing. All of these are labeled at the top, but I got to label them in front, because honestly, it's easier for me to see. And I'm chugging along here. Everything's going good. Woohoo! Look at them. Red wigglers. These are Acinia fetidas. Man, they're good looking worms. Woo-hoo! Look at them. Oh my God. So guys, I took the worms out of here that I sifted and took the bedding off to my best capacity. And I started off with 3/4 of a pound. And look how much I got. I'm telling you, it's amazing. And these are red wigglers, Acinia fetida. And they are gorgeous. So let's do a little recap to end this. I got breeders here drying out because they are just too wet. And as you can see, my wall of breeders is growing. So these are the breeders that you put in a bin, a certain amount, and you sift them at 3 weeks. Then you take the cocoons and you put them in another bin by themselves to hatch and to grow up. So this wall system, basically that's how it works. In time, you know, I will go into more details with you, but if anyone wants to get started, I mean, it's not difficult. It's just something that you really have to stay on top of, you know? So I think you all can do it. Just as long as you put your mind to something, just do it. Just be honest. Be a good worm farmer. Have good customer service. Raise what you say you're gonna ship and sell. Don't deceive people. It's naughty to do that. And just be joyful every day. Every day we get a new chance, so be joyful. My wall is expanding and it's exciting, so I can't wait to continue to bring you along on this with me.